we're asked to find the critical points and linearization of the given system. Here we're given x prime equals sine of pi y plus the square of x minus 1, and y prime equals y squared minus y. To begin, this indicates that f of x comma y is equal to sine of pi y plus the square of x minus 1, and g of x comma y is equal to y squared minus y. To determine the critical points, we determine the points where both f and g are both equal to 0, which means we need to solve the system. The sine of pi y plus the square of x minus 1 equals 0, and y squared minus y equals 0. Let's focus on the second equation first. Y squared minus y is equal to 0 when either y is 0 or y is 1. So when y is equal to 0, notice the first equation becomes sine 0 plus the square of x minus 1 equals 0. Sine 0 is 0, and the square of x minus 1 is 0 when x is 1. This gives us the critical point 1, 0. And now when y is 1, the first equation is sine pi, which is also 0, plus the square of x minus 1 equals 0. And therefore, the second critical point is 1, 1. So we have two critical points. We have the point 1, 0 and 1, 1. And now we can work on determining the linearization. We first change the variables to u and v, where u is equal to x minus x sub 0, and v is equal to y minus y sub 0, where x sub 0 comma y sub 0 is a critical point. Beginning with the critical point 1 comma 0, we have u equals x minus 1 and v equals y. Next, we determine the Jacobian matrix by determining the partials of f with respect to x and y and the partials of g with respect to x and y. Again, f of x comma y is equal to sine of pi y plus the square of x minus 1, and g of x comma y is equal to y squared minus y. For the first row of the Jacobian matrix, the partial of f with respect to x is equal to 2 times x minus 1, and the partial of f with respect to y is cosine pi y times pi, or pi cosine pi y. In the second row, we have the partial of g with respect to x, which is 0, and then we have the partial of g with respect to y, which is 2y minus 1. Next, we evaluate this at the critical point 1, 0, which gives us a 2 by 2 matrix with entries 0, pi, 0, negative 1. And therefore, the linearization is the derivative of the vector uv equals the 2 by 2 Jacobian matrix with entries 0, pi, 0, negative 1 times the vector uv. So now we know with u equal x minus 1 and v equal y, the linearization is u prime equals pi v and v prime equals negative v. And now we go through the same process again with the critical point 1, 1. For the critical point 1, 1, we now have u equals x minus 1 and v equals y minus 1. The Jacobian matrix is the same, but now we evaluate the Jacobian matrix at the point 1, 1, which gives us a 2 by 2 matrix with entries 0, negative pi, 0, 1. And therefore, the linearization, when u equals x minus 1 and v equals y minus 1, is the derivative of the vector uv equals the 2 by 2 matrix with entries 0, negative pi, 0, 1 times the vector uv. With u equal x minus 1 and v equal y minus 1, the linearization is u prime equals negative pi v and v prime equals v. Before we go, let's look at this graphically. On the left, we have the graph of the original vector field. Notice this does verify we do have critical points at 1, 0 and 1, 1. The graph in the middle shows a linearization near the point x, y equals 1, 0, which is the same as u, v equals the point 0, 0. In the last graph, we have the linearization near x, y equals 1, 1, which is the same as u, v equals 0, 0. Remember, when looking at the linearizations, the critical points will always appear at the origin. Analyzing the slope fields for the linearizations, notice how they are pretty good approximations near the critical points of the original vector field. I hope you found this helpful.